Los cristianos de Siria ahora.
I think the Christians now in Syria are very brave, those in Iraq as well. They are not brave by themselves. I think the Holy Spirit is strengthening us and accompanying us in everything. Because if it weren't like that, we wouldn't be able to continue on anymore. So the people there are stronger and firmer in their faith. They don't abandon it. Many of them don't want to leave. Many Christians don't want to leave because we consider it to be our land, and it takes part in the beginning of Christianity. Damascus is where St. Paul was converted. We are sure that without divine intervention, nothing will change. But sometimes I think that there are people who have to suffer more so that others can be saved. God would never give you something that isn't good for you or is more than you can handle. One day, all of this will be over, but faith will continue onwards. Going to Mass could mean dying, because if you are inside, they could attack you and kill you. It might mean that they plant a bomb. It could mean that on the way there, a mortar falls on you. Sometimes, like what we are seeing now, they destroy your church. There are people, and this is nice, that after the destruction of the church of Umm al-Zinar in Homs, when it was freed, they celebrated several masses there. But they also celebrated a wedding in this destroyed church, because God is there. The altar is there. The walls might be destroyed, but God is there. And they celebrated the wedding there to show that we will continue on and we're not going to stop.
Mostrar que, bueno, seguimos, no vamos a parar.
The way the Christian community reacts when faced with death is with joy, because for us, they are martyrs. We are very sad, of course, and there is a lot of sadness, especially if it's a son or a daughter. And last week, I don't know this person directly, but there's a father whose son died. His son's wedding was going to take place in 3 weeks' time. He was engaged and he worked as a lawyer. He was dressed, and this makes your hair stand on end. He came out in the funeral dressed in his wedding suit.
Oy, con el traje de novio, ¿no?
We can't have an embittered heart because what we are living is a lot less than what Jesus lived. When you are a Christian and you believe, you know that there will be persecution. We always have to pray for those who do us harm, because when they hurt us in this persecution, it probably isn't because they want to, but because they think they are doing what is right. Just like Jesus on the cross who said, "Forgive them because they do not know what they do."
Dijo, Dios, perdónales porque no saben lo que hacen. No puedo odiar. De hecho,
I can't hate. The truth is that before, I was more rebellious and unfriendly. I was even very competitive in so many things. I had to be the best to do this and that and the other. Later, one thinks things through better and sees that you can do them, but with love.
Pero con amor. Yo invito a toda la gente que...
I encourage everyone to look in the mirror and think that when they leave their house, it might be the last day that they leave their house. They have to put themselves in the shoes of the people in Syria, who when they leave their homes and they say goodbye to their mother, their wife, their father, and all of their loved ones, they don't know if they will ever see them again or not.